phones would be unveiled on October 4th, and now the Pixel and the Pixel XL are back with more leaked photos. As you can see, both phones seem to be made of aluminum primarily. The front is a similar story, a slate of glass on top of the display, relatively slim side bezels, and a few sensors above. The only difference between the Pixel and the Pixel XL seems to be the size. They are rumored to be a 5.2-inch display and a 5.5-inch display, respectively. One thing is for sure, however, the Pixel phones are positively HTC. They look very similar to the HTC A9, and by association, Google's upcoming phones look very similar to the iPhone, for better or for worse. To refresh your memory, the regular Pixel phone will likely come with a 5.2-inch Full HD display, powered by a Snapdragon 820. The Pixel XL will probably sport a 5.5-inch Quad HD display, and is said to be coming with either a revised version of the Snapdragon 820 chipset or the Snapdragon 821. Both devices should feature an identical 12-megapixel rear cam and an 8-megapixel selfie shooter. Now, the latest news suggests that these phones might be a bit more expensive than previous Nexus handsets, with prices potentially starting at $649. Ouch. To soften the damage on your wallet, however, the same source also suggests that Google will introduce financing options with the Pixel. What else can we expect from this mysterious October 4th date? Well, we're expecting that Google will also reintroduce stuff that they talked about at Google I.O. To start with, Google Home. Remember Google Home? It's pretty much a direct competitor to the Amazon Echo, but with Google services baked into its core. It's much like a stationary Google Assistant. Some of the core features include the ability to answer your questions using Google Search, track weather, provide other information, and organize your itinerary. The gadget can also play your music or cast content to other supported devices. It should be a neat, smart product to have around, and the cost is said to be around $120. Are you convinced? Next up, we also expect Chromecast to receive an upgrade called Chromecast Ultra. We've been hearing rumors of a supercharged Chromecast, and it will likely be named Chromecast Ultra. This will be a 4K-capable Chromecast that is now rumored to cost approximately $69 US. What about Google Wi-Fi, particularly if you're not very happy with Google's on-hub routers? Google is said to be coming up with a brand new router that will take your internet further, literally. Google Wi-Fi's main feature is the ability to link together multiple access points to create one large wireless network. In essence, it would be a simplified, albeit glorified, system of Wi-Fi range extenders, or at least that's what it seems like it'll be. It would be great for large houses or offices, especially considering how easy it is to operate one of Google's routers. It is believed that the administrator can simply operate Google Wi-Fi through the OnHub app. It should have smart features, but don't expect too much. The rumored price is $129, which is much cheaper than OnHub routers. Oh, this hurts to talk about. Oh, right in the feels. I was only going to talk about Google's October 4th event, but we just heard like 12 hours ago that BlackBerry is getting out of the smartphone market. They are not going to make smartphone hardware anymore. They're just going to focus on software. Dang. For those of you who are much younger, BlackBerry was the behemoth. They were the dominant smartphone maker for like 10, 12 years. I mean, there's a whole name for people like that. They're called Crackberries. And now, you know, if you only got a smartphone 5 years ago, you wouldn't understand this. But they were as big as Google. Bigger, because this is before Apple made the iPhone. They were just massive, right? I mean, anyone who wanted real work done and they wanted a smartphone, you got a BlackBerry, and they called you a Crackberry because you were always on it. It's just so sad. It's just the end of an era. You know, for analysis-wise, it's too early to tell. Let's hope they can pivot into something else like IBM did. We'll see. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. You guys remember from like 15 years ago when people were making money?